Michaela, this is Junior, and I'm Louise, and I'm Jayla's mummy. And we just thought we'd talk to you about Jayla's little problems that she's been having since birth and what medicines we've been trying her with and what we find that's helped her in the last month or so after trying thousands and thousands of medicines. We found the naturalist one that's given her a new lease of life, and just want to tell people about it really, and just might give more people hope. She come into the world so beautiful with all her hair, and we thought, wow, she was just stunning. Everyone was just complimenting how beautiful she was and how much of a good baby she was. You know, she wouldn't cry all the time, and she was just smiling and so peaceful. But then at 12 months of age, she still wasn't walking or talking. Okay, pizza's coming now. She still wasn't walking or talking, but again, I thought it was just physical development delay. There was no signs of anything, you know, we just thought we had a late developer, so to speak, you know. And then she had problems pooing, and that was the first sign of any problems going wrong. It's an occasion. First ever instance of Jayla stopping breathing, she was pooing. And she's going blue, stop breathing through pooing. Oh, run outside with her in my arms, somebody help me. Oh, she was just gone, and that was the first ever instance of her stopping breathing. Took her to ambulance, took her to hospital. I said, oh, sometimes babies stop breathing. Thinking about it, no, that was just weird. No, they just say that, no investigations. Week later, it happened again. This time the ambulance, they couldn't get her out of the seizures. By then it was a natural seizure, it was an hour and a half. Ever in a fit of state, blue, like trying to get her out of something what she was in, you know. And it was just traumatising. I was heavily pregnant with Junior. I went into early labour with him at 33 weeks, hanging over our bed on the rhesus table. So I was getting carted off in an ambulance while she was just horrific. And then they thought it was just epilepsy. She's four now. She has seizures every 3 to 4 weeks that last 5 to 10 days. And what will happen is her arms will go up. She'll go, hold her breath in, arms go up, start shaking, going blue. She'll need suction, but her mouth locks up. And then she's foaming at the mouth, so you'll need to suction and oxygen at the same time while aspirating all the milk out of her stomach. She'll just be sick, it all out of her nose and mouth, and that'll make her stop breathing. It's just horrific, like it's just like an A&E department at our home when this is happening. So again, and then she's having these seizures every hour, every 2 hours or whatnot. Last, she's smiling. Can you hear your mummy? And they just don't stop, and then they can start to come like 5 in an hour when this starts. We know that we've got to take her in an ambulance. Bleeding will start to come in the stomach. Just too much seizures. And we get there, they have to cannulate her. Load her, drug her up. Doesn't work. She's still having seizures through it. They have to jaw thrust down. She's like, you know, her breathing in the stomach. It's going in and out. It just looks like she's going to take her last breath. She's just got a new lease of life within the last few months since we've been trying the oil. She's just got a new lease of life, and she's just so in awe of the world, and she's awake all day. And it's took us 3 years just to find a suitable drug, and it's been down to me and everyone else to find it, not the NHS or the doctors, you know. It dramatically reduced her seizures, so they weren't coming every hour or so, they was coming ever so often. But she wasn't comatised in each one. She was like waking up from them, just like, oh, I've just had a seizure. But it's just to see her watching the telly and stuff like that, you know, it's just in awe. She's just looking at her and smiling. I just know she knows what life is now.